What's up guys, in this video we're going to be doing a comparison of the second generation Apple TV, the old model, to the new third generation Apple TV. So on the new Apple TV, it's not what it looks like that counts, it's what's on the inside. I'm hot. On the older second generation Apple TV, it features Apple's A4 processor, whereas the new third generation Apple TV features Apple's A5 processor, obviously making it a lot faster and more snappy. Not only that, but the older generation Apple TV offered up to 720p video, whereas the new model offers up to 1080p video. Like I mentioned before, the new model looks exactly like the old model, and so does the box. Except for, of course, over here on the side, it says it offers 1080p video rather than 720p. And of course, the box contains the same contents as a previous model. Of course, you get the power cable, you get the Apple TV itself, and you get the Apple TV remote. The Apple TV remote has an up, down, left, right button, as well as the center button in the middle. And of course, it's got the menu and play pause buttons. Now at Apple's keynote where they announced the new Apple TV, they kind of tried to fool us. They said that the new Apple TV with a software update will have the new UI, which I'll show you in just a minute. But they didn't mention that the old second generation Apple TV will also get the UI update. So just in case you're planning on buying the new Apple TV for the new UI, don't worry, you're going to get it on the second generation also. Although take into account this is the new model and it does have the faster A5 processor, so I expect Apple to release more apps and be able to do more stuff on the newer model than you can the previous old generation Apple TV. So with that being said, at the current moment in time, the only new features in the new Apple TV third generation to the second generation is 1080p video streaming and the new A5 processor. But again, with some software updates, depending on how much Apple supports the older Apple TV, that may change. Now one thing I was interested in is, will the new A5 processor improve AirPlay mirroring from your iPhone, iPad to your Apple TV? From what I've seen and tried, I don't think there's really any difference from the new generation to the old generation. I think it morally depends on your internet speed and how reliable it is. But now let me take a minute to actually show you through the new user interface on the Apple TV software update. So here's the new user interface on the Apple TV. Up here at the top, you've got your top movies. It also show your purchase over there. You can browse through these. It's basically obviously just top movies that iTunes is recommending. These are actually from the iTunes store. If you scroll down, you see that we have a more iOS looking layout now with icons. First you got movies, you got TV shows, music, computers. And by the way, music now, this is a new feature in the new update. You can actually, if you have iTunes Match, use your iTunes Match library and stream music from the cloud to your Apple TV, not having to be connected to your computer or streaming it from an iOS device. Also, computers, that's where you can connect to your home sharing network. And you can stream everything from there. That was a feature already. You got the settings button now. If you click on any of these, it looks exactly the same as it did on the previous version of the Apple TV software update. It's not the best layout ever, because it is just text, but it looks alright. They will have images over here where the Apple TV is, depending on what you're looking at. I'll show you that in just a second. Let me go over here to movies. This is what the layout looks for movies. I don't think this has changed that much. They got featured movies up here, which you can scroll left and right through. And then you got top movies, new releases, and you can scroll to the right on these. And then recent arrivals from small screen to big screen, epic adventures, Irish movies. So they kind of got some sections that they think you might be interested in. So there you go. That's pretty much the movies tab, and the TV shows tab looks also the same. But up here at the top, you can go see your purchase shows, so you can see everything that you've purchased. I haven't signed into my Apple ID yet. You got your Genius feature, which will actually recommend stuff for you to watch based on what you've watched previously. Genres, so you can actually browse through different types of movies. Then you got search, where you can search for a movie, or you can even see trailers for movies. So back to the layout itself. Again, you got TV shows, which looks pretty much exactly the same. You got everything up there at the top. Only thing I do see differently is networks, so you can actually browse through TV shows by networks. So yeah, you got the settings, then you got Netflix, which all these apps were already on the previous software update for the Apple TV, but they just got the new UI. So Netflix, you can now actually create a Netflix account on the Apple TV. I haven't connected my Netflix to it yet, but you will get access if you have the new Apple TV to the 1080p content on Netflix, which there isn't too much, but as you see here, You can start your 1 month free trial, or you can go ahead and sign in there if you're already a member. So Netflix on Apple TV looks nice, but none of the stuff, like the actual apps itself, has a new UI update. It's basically just the home screen. Then you got NBA, NHL, you got trailers. This is kind of a new thing as its own button. So you can basically just go through all the trailers opening soon. You got top movies. It's taking a second to load. That's just because my internet is acting up. But yeah, so you can browse through your trailers. You got MLB TV, so you can watch baseball. Wall Street Journal Live. I can't remember if this is an app on the previous software update or not. I think this is new. But this is basically the Wall Street Journal video content. You can watch live now. They're actually working on bringing a lot of live content to the new Apple TV, which I expect to see a lot more of once they get deals worked out with more partners and stuff like that. So that's one thing you could expect to see new in the Apple TV. Of course, you got the YouTube app, which looks just as it did before. Not the best way to browse through YouTube, but it is all right. So you got most viewed, featured, stuff like that. Actually, well, I'm not going to go, but YouTube actually just featured my new iPad giveaway recently. I'm not sure if we'll be able to find it on here. Yeah, I'm going to have to load a lot more videos. But this is basically YouTube, so you can watch YouTube on the Apple TV. You could do this on the previous software update and the previous version also. Yeah, I don't know where my video is. It might be a long ways down. But yeah. Anyways, that is YouTube on the new Apple TV. I kind of want to see if I can find my video. Anyways, we'll go back. All right, so next is the Vimeo app, which this was already on there, except now it's just an icon. I'm not going to show you that. It's Vimeo. You got podcasts, which looks exactly the same also, so you can browse through all the podcasts on iTunes. You got radio, so you can actually listen to the radio. They got all kinds of different genres and stuff like that. That you can pick from, and there's tons in each one of these different radio stations you can listen to. Of course, you got Flickr, you got MobileMe, which soon will be removed because MobileMe is service is dying soon. Then you got PhotoStream. You can basically, if you log into your Apple ID, you can see all of your photos that you've taken on your iOS devices and stuff like that synced across all your devices, so you can show people really quickly on your Apple TV. So basically the only things that I know are new is, of course, iTunes Match. So you can browse through your iTunes Match content if you have that subscription service, which costs $25 a year. And then you can listen to it on your Apple TV playing through the cloud, as well as 1080p content through iTunes, which from what I know, there isn't too much. Maybe I'm wrong about that. And Netflix, which there definitely isn't a lot of 1080p content on that. But there you go. There's a look at the new UI on the Apple TV. Now, before we head out of here, let's take one last look at our sponsor for this video, Gamefly. Gamefly is the world's largest online video game rental service, offering you a choice of over 7,000 new and classic titles across all consoles and handhelds. With plans starting at just $15.95 a month, Gamefly members can rent 1 to 4 games at a time and keep them for as long as they like. There are no late fees or due dates, and shipping is always free. Once you're done playing a game, send it back and Gamefly will send you the next available game on your list. If you really like the game that you're playing, simply click Keep It on the Gamefly's website and the game is yours at a discounted price, and they will even send you the case and manuals free of charge. You guys can sign up now and get a 15-day free trial. Just go to gamefly.com/tie. Make sure to use that URL so they know that I sent you. So there you go. There's a quick comparison of the new Apple TV third generation to the old second generation Apple TV. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button down below and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll have a lot more videos on the new iPad as well as my review on the new Apple TV. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think about the new generation. Is it worth it or is it not worth it compared to the old generation? And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.